Four people ended up in the hospital today after a boarding house caught fire in Cherokee County. As News 4's Mike McCormick found out, a lot of quick thinking saved all the lives inside that building, even without sprinklers or smoke detectors.
The fire chief tells us it'll likely be a couple of days before they figure out what caused the fire here, but witnesses think that fire started in this section of the building, maybe even in the room where you see those firefighters working. The fire was so intense it forced people to jump for their lives.
Around 5 a.m., a frantic knock from a neighbor woke up Clint Hall.
By the time I got up, the fire started on the bottom floor, and it was already up to the top, second floor, and that's where I'm at.
Thick smoke kept him from going downstairs.
Right in front of my room, their window. So we jump out the window. I mean, I showed them how it done. I was the first one to jump out.
As Hall and others escaped on their own, Cherokee County Deputy Nick Federico got there, beating the fire department.
There were some people under the second story, and they had made their way there, and then there was a couple on the ground, and it looked like they had a sheet tied, and they was coming down that sheet.
He and Deputy Benji Peterson helped pull a man through a window.
I cleared all the glass out of the window, and the guy kept telling me he was disabled. And I told him, we're going to get you out.
All 33 people who lived at this very old boarding house off Cherokee Avenue got out, including the building manager and her infant child.
Thank God that, you know, Red Cross helping us out and stuff.
At Cherokee Avenue Baptist Church, the Red Cross set up a makeshift shelter.
And I just thank God, you know, everybody's out and okay.
For now, the cots here will give Clint Hall a place to sleep and nurse his bruised foot from the jump that saved his life.
Oh, it's a miracle. You know, I mean, I could have been dead a few times, but I mean, I reckon the good Lord still got me around for a reason.
If you would like to help the victims of this fire, you can donate money to the local Red Cross office in your area. We've also put the contact information on WIFF4.com. Mike McCormick, WIFF News 4 in Gaffney.
And we need to give a shout out of thanks here. Our you local reporters were a big help in telling this story this morning. In fact, Henry Jolly took these pictures of the fire and he put them on you local. And, of course, we put them on the air. If you have pictures you'd like to share, just upload them to U Local right there on WIFF4.com.